The Lakers have won their last two games, maybe not against the most difficult competition, a very injured 76ers team, as well as a diminished Raptors team missing Scottie Barnes. But still, on the court, we're starting to see the Lakers really buy in to the schemes of J.J. Redick. They talked about it quite a bit after the game, and I want to get into some of their comments, specifically some really important things shared by J.J., Austin Reeves, and D'Angelo Russell. But first, quick reminder, do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. We're going to keep you up to date on all things Lakers. All right, here we go. Let's get right to it here. This is J.J. Redick last night talking about the team's buy-in. He said, "I'm excited about our team's defense the last two games. It hasn't been 100%, and I don't think a team in the NBA is 100%. What's promising is whether it's been a day between games, a film session, a practice, or things we emphasize, they're responsive. There's a trust that is building between players and between players and staff. Holistically, in terms of our offense and defense, there's a long way to go. That, to me, is more exciting." Okay, so first and foremost, that's a phenomenal quote from J.J. Redick, where he's talking about the trust that's being built between the players themselves as well as the players and the staff. He mentions the defense. Yes, it was better the last two games. Again, not the highest quality opponents, but the Lakers ranked 26th in the NBA over the course of the season in defensive rating, 13th. Over the last two games. Now, transition defense, it continues to be a problem. In fact, Raptors wing Ochai Agbaji actually called out the Lakers at halftime, essentially said, "We know they don't want to get back." Everybody in the NBA knows right now the Lakers' transition defense is a big, big problem, and they're going to continue to try to pick on the Lakers there as long as they possibly can. Until the Lakers put a stop to it, opponents are going to continue to try to crush the Lakers by getting out in transition. In fact, as of right now, the Lakers currently sit 29th in the NBA in opponents' fast break points. That is not good. But JJ's saying we're seeing buy-in from the players, and they are starting to compete. We saw it in last night's game against the Raptors, particularly in the second half. They really cut down on the second chance scoring opportunities for Toronto. Did a nice job there adjusting. And as JJ is saying, the team is responding to what he's suggesting. To that end, Austin Reeves, Lakers guard who had an excellent game last night, said, "You wish it was smooth sailing the whole time. You're going to go through ups and downs. I think not playing well on the road trip might have been a good thing for us to completely buy into what we knew we needed to do to be successful." Okay, let me pause right there for just a moment. The road trip was frustrating, certainly. A 1-4 road trip, not what we wanted to see for the Lakers. But as Austin is saying, maybe the silver lining is it hammered home that we have to buy in. We have to buy in, otherwise we're going to lose, and nobody wants that. That doesn't feel good. So the silver lining of the 1-4 road trip is that the Lakers got the message that you have to buy in to what the coaching staff wants from you. So take a look at the rest of this here. "Our coaches are putting us in the position to be successful. When we buy in and do it, good things happen. Even if it's a game plan adjustment, they'll come in and say, 'We messed up. We need to do this instead.' Everybody's just kind of holding each other accountable. So it's a beautiful thing to see." All right, so that struck me, what Austin said right there at the end. "Even if it's a game plan adjustment, they'll come in and say, 'We messed up. We need to do this instead.' Everybody is kind of holding each other accountable." Think about that. So from a player's perspective, not only are the coaches holding the players accountable, right? And players are going to get called out if they're not performing up to expectations. We've seen J.J. Redick do that. But they're holding themselves accountable too. What a concept, right? The coaches are holding themselves accountable. The coaches are coming in and saying, "Hey, we messed up. This game plan didn't work because of these reasons. Instead, we need to shift to this." And I think there's a respect factor there from the players, because we've seen in the past, and this is not just a last season thing, this is a common thing around the NBA, where coaches will often try to deflect blame. Not every coach, but some coaches will try to deflect blame and pass it on to the players. From what Austin is saying, the coaching staff, if things aren't going well, they will say, "Hey, this is where we blew it. We made a mistake in our tactical planning here. The tactics we deployed were wrong, and this is how we're going to fix it." And I think that creates a level of respect from players. I'd like to hear more about this dynamic here, but to me, that just jumps out as a great thing to be hearing from Austin Reeves. Again, and it's not been all great for the Lakers. They're 6-4. They had opportunities to win other games that they weren't able to take care of. We know where this team is at. We know they're not an upper echelon team right now. We know trades need to be made and everything. But as JJ was talking about, big picture, even though things are not where the Lakers need them to be, they're on a good path here. And if there is that respect being built, that trust being built between the players and the coaching staff holding them, not just the players, but holding themselves accountable, that's a good sign. Not necessarily that they're suddenly going to turn into this juggernaut team overnight, but for the long-term future. Now, the best way to catch an NBA game is live and in person, and the best way to do it is with SeatGeek. With 28 million downloads, SeatGeek is the number one ticketing app. They have 70,000 different events that you can check out, including sporting events, concerts, festivals, and tons more. The great thing about SeatGeek is they've got a wonderful rating system, which lets you know the quality of the tickets that you're buying. They're rated 1 through 10. Green means good, red means bad, and they're pulling tickets from all over the web, so you know that you're getting a good deal. Personally, what I really love, too, is that you get a preview of the seats. You can see what the view is going to look like from the seats that you are selecting, so a great way to know exactly what your vantage point of the floor is going to look like. And you know what came through for you guys? You can use my code LakersNation to get $20 off your tickets with SeatGeek. Use that code again, LakersNation, $20 off your first purchase with SeatGeek. Click the link in the description below to download the app. Now, take a look here. D'Angelo Russell. D'Lo had this, and I'm not going to go through everything he said here, but he said, if I can leave you with something, I think once again, you just want to commit to that system that the coaches are trying to implement. It makes everybody's job easier. It allows us to see how they're guarding us early, always allows us to see how teams are guarding us from game to game. I believe D'Lo right there is talking about some of the schemes the Lakers are deploying, some of the little dribble handoffs and things like that. They're basically testing their opponents to see, okay, if we do this, how are you going to react? Okay, that's how you're guarding us? Great. This is how we're going to counter it then. It's adapting on the fly, which I think is a really important thing. He said, I think our team is preparing for the postseason with these 82 games to try to get better every game, trying to see how teams guard us, trying to see what we can do to prepare ourselves for the postseason because it's all unfamiliar. So just committing to it. Remember, D'Angelo Russell has been asked to commit in a big, big way. He's in a contract year, a lot of money on the line for him next summer, and he's already been moved to the bench and been asked to accept a bench role. Not an easy thing to do. But so far, so good. So far, he's done it, and I think the Lakers have been better off for it. Now, D'Lo also, I love this quote. I love this quote right here. D'Lo says, I think if we can find a way to be unselfishly selfish. What a great phrase, unselfishly selfish. It sounds contradictory, but it makes sense on the basketball court. So check this out. He said, I think that that will help our guys that are supposed to be selfish and more hungry for what they're trying to do. It's easy for us to follow those guys. Obviously, Austin and AD and Braun carrying the load allows us as the supporting cast to be that much more effective. Interesting that he listed Austin Reeves as one of the guys carrying the load. Now, Austin certainly did in last night's game, but still just interesting that he included Austin Reeves in with Anthony Davis and LeBron James. As the supporting cast to be that much more effective because now we see teams have to guard those guys. They have to adjust. They have to game plan. You've got to be ready. Guys like myself, Dalton, Jackson, Rui, Gabe, it's a lot of opportunity. So again, D'Lo saying, telling everybody that'll listen, we have to buy in. And he has been asked to buy in probably more than anyone else in terms of the major shift that he's been asked to undertake here. But also saying, if we can find ways to be unselfishly selfish. I look at that and I read that as, and you guys can tell me in the comment section if you read this differently, but I read that as the role players, they've got to be aggressive. They can't just sit back and allow LeBron to do what LeBron's going to do and AD to do what he's going to do and just say, hey, we're along for the ride. They've got to be out there making plays too. When the opportunities are there, they've got to take them. And what that's going to do, it's going to show defenses that they have to guard those guys. And that's going to create opportunities, more opportunities for LeBron. It all goes around and around. Teams focus on LeBron and AD. That's going to create open looks for D'Lo, for Rui, for Austin, for everybody else, right? That's going to create those open looks. And if those guys are aggressive and those guys are hitting those shots, D'Lo's knocking down shots, Rui's knocking down shots, on and on, well, that's going to take some of the pressure off of LeBron and Anthony Davis as they get you know, more and more attention paid to them, and teammates are able to capitalize. So I think that phrase, unselfishly selfish, it's actually a very accurate way to look at it. When the shot's there, D'Lo's got to take it, and he's got to knock it down. Same thing with Rui. They've got to make the plays when those plays are there to be made, and that is going to benefit the team overall. It's being selfish knowing that it's not so much for you, but it's taking the opportunities that are there because you know it's going to help everybody. Great quote by D'Angelo Russell. Loved what he said there. So again, it's not like all is right in the world of the Lakers. They won two games against two pretty poor teams, against the Raptors and against a very, very injured Philadelphia 76ers side. But I think there's something to what JJ's saying about the buy-in. I thought particularly in the second half of last night's game, after doing the same old thing in the first half, giving up tons of second chance scoring opportunities, tons of fast break points, we saw the Lakers really buy in, really buckle down in the second half of last night's game. And hopefully that is a sign of things to come. Next up, the Lakers take on the Memphis Grizzlies on Wednesday. That's going to be at home, a rematch there. Ja Morant out right now due to injury. I know everybody probably thinks Ja's coming back for specifically to play the Lakers, but they're also missing Desmond Bane. Marcus Smart has been out. We'll see who's available for them day after tomorrow when they take on the Lakers in LA. But hopefully, fingers crossed, the Lakers will be able to continue their winning streak and push it to three games against Memphis. And hopefully, Anthony Davis, we're still waiting on word for him from him on the eye injury. Hopefully he will be able to play as well after not being able to complete last night's game after getting poked in the eye by Jakob Poeltl. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. What do you think about the level of buy-in that we've seen from this Lakers team so far? Don't forget to subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, see you and stay safe.